Hare Krishna. Treat the mind like a child. Don't let the mind treat you like a child. If we are working with a child, or we are getting a child to do some homework or do something, we know by nature that the child will be restless and the child will be fickle, and the child needs to be focused by the parent or the guide. Now, if the child wants to play, neglecting studies, the child may need to play sometime, but the parent has to be responsible to keep the play within regulation. If the child becomes so whimsical, so demanding, so forceful, emotionally forceful, that the child makes the parent like a child, and the child is playing and the parent also starts playing, and the parent forgets all responsibilities, then the child will be doomed. Child's future will be very dark indeed. Our mind is like a child. The Bhagavad Gita describes that the mind is chanchala. In the Gita 6th chapter, 34th verse, Arjun says, chanchala himana Krishna pramathi balavadrudham tasyaham nigraham manye vayorivasudushkaram. Says the chanchalam himana Krishna, the mind is like a child. However, this is not just a restless, weak child. Pramathi balavadrudham. It's obstinate, it's strong, and it's wild. And therefore, regulating it is extremely difficult. Now, how do we learn to regulate the mind? By, first of all, recognizing that the mind is like a child and not expecting it to be like an adult. The mind will be fickle. It'll like one thing today, another thing tomorrow. In fact, it'll like one thing at one moment, and a few moments later, it'll throw that thing away to go to some other thing. Now, we can't be that fickle. So, we need to become like a parent. And how do we become like a parent? What differentiates a parent from a child? It is maturity. It is intelligence. It is the capacity to see the big picture. It is the capacity to see the long-term consequences of one's actions. The child simply wants to play, but the parent sees that this child's career and future will be bright if the child studies now. So, such broadening of our perspective, such expansion of our intelligence happens by the study of the Bhagavad Gita. So, when we nourish our intelligence, when we equip ourselves with Gita wisdom, then although the mind may continue to be childish, but we will be mature like an adult, and we will be able to train and retrain, restrain and retrain the mind. Restrain so that it doesn't go off in unwanted directions, or we pull it back when it goes off in unwanted directions, and retrain it so that it will become focused. And ultimately, the best way to focus the mind is by focusing it on the source of the mind and the source of everything, that is Krishna. He is all attractive, and to the extent we focus on Him, to that extent not only do we grow up, but even the mind grows up. At that time, when the mind grows up, it becomes our friend, and then it helps us in leading a meaningful and a fulfilling life. Thank you. Hare Krishna.